So in today's video, we're doing something different. You guys know I'm usually a makeup channel, but I get a lot of questions about my sweaters. I wear sweaters a lot, I mean, especially this time of the year, and you guys have been asking me over and over in the comments where I get my sweaters, what style of sweaters I like. So I figured I would just show you my whole sweater collection, try them on for you guys, and give you some tips when you're looking for sweaters. I'm a sweater person. You know how some people are like, they're a shoe person, they are a jeans person. For me, a good sweater just does something for me. I also get a lot of questions about my earrings, and in specific, I've been wearing these earrings a lot. These are the Abby Hoops from Ana Luisa, and this portion of the video is sponsored by Ana Luisa, so thank you so much to Ana Luisa. So I really, really like a classic style, whether it's my sweaters or my earrings. I really like a classic look that is going to last me a long time, and these Abby Hoops, these are like the perfect pair of hoops when you are wearing a sweater because they're shorter, but they're a little bit chunkier. It's a very classic, but also modern style. And I just find that their styles, they hit different, you know? They're just really, really well thought out. You can definitely get something with a little bit more sparkle. Your cruise huggies are really nice if you just want a little bit of sparkle, but I love the Rocks Minis. That's just really the perfect little mini huggy hoop if you are looking for something very minimal and simple. But these Abby Hoops, my absolute favorite. They are doing a big sale right now. They're doing buy one, get one 40% off. So, you know, if you are looking something for that special someone, or if you're looking something for you, you can look on their website and check out all of their styles. Also in the United States, if you spend $150, you get a beautiful travel case for free. Their prices are really fair too. So they have some pieces starting at like $39, or you can go up into like the higher end price range as well. All the pieces I have are 14 karat gold plated, which is amazing. I'm definitely a person that likes to invest in a good pair of earrings or a good sweater rather than, you know, finding a style I like and then after a week it looks tarnished or crappy. They also offset 100% of their carbon emissions, so they are carbon neutral. I love that about Ana Luisa. So now is as good a time as any to check out their products. I will have a link down below and more details on the sale if you guys are interested. And thank you again so much to Ana Luisa for sponsoring this portion of the video. So now, let's get into all of my sweaters. If you guys enjoyed today's video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you like me, I would love to have you back. So make sure to subscribe as well. All right, so first let's start off with a cardigan. So I really, really enjoy this cardigan. I'm definitely not someone that has a lot of cardigans, only because I tend to be very picky with the ones that I like. I like for them to be kind of a complement to an entire outfit, to be a little bit more shapely. And I also really like cardigans with buttons. I'm not as big of a fan of like a looser cardigan that, you know, covers your butt and is more flowy. This one from Madewell is really, really nice because one, I really like the buttons. It's also pretty cozy. It's not itchy. So if I did decide to wear short sleeves with this, I could definitely do that. This is a size medium, so it is a little bit looser, but because of the fabric, I find that it really looks good and is very form-fitting, but not like tight by any means. So this is 73% wool and 27% polyamide. Let's first mention that I'm not a huge fabric expert, but I have found the kind of fabric blends that I really like. I love this cardigan. I love the color as well. I find that this kind of like burnt sienna kind of color is really, really pretty on probably every single skin tone, and it's more neutral. So I am a very, very big fan of this one. I'm literally just dropping all of my sweaters onto this dog bed. Probably not a good move, but I digress. Let's move forward into one of my older sweaters. It's a sweater that I invested in a long time ago, and I just really am happy that I did that. I really am an investment kind of person. I would rather spend $100 on a sweater than 20 and only get, you know, 2 years out of wear out of that sweater. Whereas this one I've had, I mean, maybe since high school. So this is my big hairy American Apparel turtleneck. It's a one size oversized turtleneck that they came out with a long time ago. I used to purchase a lot of clothes from American Apparel back in the day in high school. I haven't purchased anything from them in like years, so I'm not sure how the quality is, but I am going to try and link similar items for you guys down below, even if they don't still make this. So this is, again, a one size wool sweater from American Apparel. A style that I have always loved is a huge turtleneck. See, this is kind of like a cross between a turtleneck and a cowl neck. I also really love a cowl neck, but this has a little bit more structure and it's just thicker, so it kind of reads more as a turtleneck. This wool is not really heavy or scratchy. This actually went through the wash, unfortunately, but it used to be really, really oversized. But since it did go through the wash accidentally from my boyfriend, I think it was my boyfriend. See, but here's the thing. I don't even remember because I don't care. Basically what it did is it shrunk it a little bit, but because this was already so oversized, it didn't really matter. It actually just made it a little bit shorter on the end, which just means that a little bit of my butt shows now, which is not a bad thing. I think I have a good butt, but it's still very chunky and oversized. I can't even tell you, just I feel great when I have this sweater on. I love how oversized it is. It's very warm, but I think there's just a level of oversized elegance. You know, there are some oversized pieces that just look kind of frumpy, but because of this really, really big turtleneck, you can see that it has almost like a ribbed look that goes down vertically. It kind of tricks the eye into making you look a little bit more slender, but it's also still oversized. So again, I really highly, highly recommend just investing in a very good black wool sweater that is a little bit more of an oversized look. I do have more of a classic kind of fisherman style without the turtleneck that I'll show you guys later. But a good black sweater, whether it's a turtleneck or not, I think is definitely a staple. So another one that I really love, I bought this last year. Actually, it was a gift from my mom. I kind of did the thing though that I just sent her exactly what I wanted and she got it for me. I love that, like, eventually you get to that point with your parents or your friends and you're just like, this is exactly what I want, and they can buy it for you and it's like, okay, cool. But this is a Reformation sweater with a very oversized sleeve. And I am not a huge fan of like a bell sleeve like this. I think this is called a bell sleeve. You guys, I'm not a fashion YouTuber, but you can see that it's a wide sleeve with a horizontal stripe. This is black with more of a cream colored stripe. I just think that this is such an incredible sweater. It was definitely over $100, maybe like $120, but when I tell you that this is one of the softest sweaters that I've ever owned, I mean it. This is so soft. This is a size small and it is 100% yak, so it is very, very soft, and it's also quite warm, and it still has some movement to it. So even though this is more on the oversized side, it's definitely one of those really cozy sweaters, but it's also really elegant. So highly, highly recommend a sweater of this material and also this style. But if you are looking for a sweater that is not as expensive as a sweater like that, but is still good quality, I really, really enjoy Madewell sweaters. Just like the cardigan, I think their sweaters are really, really cozy and the styles are really flattering. So I have this one. They used to come out with this sweater like every single year, and they redid their sweater line and they came out with these ones instead. I have this purple one. I will leave it linked down below, but this is kind of like a dark purple shade. I wear extra small in these style of their sweaters, but this is just a deal in my opinion. It is so incredibly soft. It's 40% acrylic, 30% polyamide, 24% wool, 4% alpaca, and 2% elastane. So this is a really movable sweater and it just looks really flattering. I find that this style of sweater just looks really nice because it is a little bit more form-fitting. Sometimes you want that out of a sweater. Most of these are really oversized sweaters. This one that I bought this year is certainly a sweater that I'm wearing all the time. And this one again was probably from 2 years ago now. And I liked this one because it was a turtleneck. It was a little bit of a looser turtleneck that I thought was really, really nice. I love this color. I really like dark green, obviously, from my background. I think it's just a nice color to go with my hair. But yeah, I would definitely recommend checking out those sweaters from Madewell. Next up, let's talk about the sweater that I am wearing today. This is from L.L. Bean and it is a vintage find that I was able to pick up. I believe this is also 100% wool. I am a very, very big fan of L.L. Bean sweaters. I have a few L.L. Bean sweaters in here. This one I got on eBay, and really all of my vintage sweaters that I have are either from my mom, like they used to be hers, or I have bought them on eBay. So I really highly recommend checking out eBay for secondhand wool sweaters, because they can be quite expensive if you buy them new, obviously, but they will last you a really, really long time. So if you find a more vintage style that you enjoy, definitely jump on it. I got this one for, I think, $45, including shipping. I love the little flecks of color within this. Definitely has like a cable knit vibe on the front. And it's certainly more chunky. This is definitely not a sweater that is really going to complement every curve on your body, but I don't mind that. I really like it. And this definitely isn't the softest sweater either. It's not really, really plush. I mean, some wool sweaters are a little bit itchy. I don't find that this one is itchy. Honestly, I look at L.L. Bean sweaters. You can look at Cabela's sweaters. I definitely recommend that as well. And also look at Polo, because Polo does a lot of nice wool sweaters as well. I love how stiff this turtleneck is. Again, I really like a good chunky turtleneck, so I think that this one is really flattering. Another L.L. Bean sweater I have is this one. This is a style that they still have on their website. It's one that they constantly bring back because it's kind of like a classic within their line. This one I got from my mom though. The amount of hair on all of my clothes, I mean, it's a mix of Kit's hair, it's a mix of my hair. It's mostly my hair though, I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, she has had this for years, you guys, and now I have it, and it is just a great investment. So if you are looking for this one, they do still have it and it'll last you a really, really long time. I can't even tell you, I love this style so much. It has these white flecks on it. It just goes with everything. It's a beautiful navy color with these little cream accents to it. Again, 100% wool. I don't find this to be super, super soft. I mean, this is vintage, so it definitely has had a little bit of wear and tear on it. But in actuality, if you're wearing a big chunky wool sweater, you should probably be wearing something under it. Definitely have some other sweaters that you wouldn't need to do that, and I'll talk about those later. But I think one of the best investments that you can make is to buy a black turtleneck that you can wear under literally any of your sweaters, and focus on getting a really lightweight one. This one is from American Apparel. I've had it for a very long time. You can get them at Uniqlo though. I also have one from Madewell that I really like from their like featherweight line. It's really good quality as well. You've probably already seen that I style most of my sweaters with a black turtleneck. I mean, I'm wearing one and I already have a turtleneck on, so can you tell that I'm kind of obsessed with turtlenecks? So yeah, I definitely recommend this sweater from L.L. Bean. I also have this wool cardigan from L.L. Bean. Unfortunately, there's not a size on here, but I imagine this would be a medium as well. And this is a medium cardigan. This is honestly pretty freaking soft. This is definitely more of like an 80s kind of style sweater. I also bought it on eBay. I think it's pretty, and it's definitely one of the more soft wools that I've had. This though is, I think, my favorite sweater I own. And it's this one from John Ashford. It's a large, it is a worsted wool. I'm not sure what that means, but it is this beautiful Fair Island style sweater. I love this color combination. It's this beautiful eggplant color with these really deep green accents on it. Those are like, again, like two colors that I immediately really like and I think complement my hair color and my skin color. And you can see around the collar that it is a little bit more taut. It has a little bit more structure, but the sweater as a whole is quite soft, and it's 100% wool, but it is still nice and soft. I love the accents on the sleeves. This is just absolutely gorgeous. My mom used to wear it. I don't even think I realized how gorgeous this sweater was back then, but now obviously it's, you know, definitely my favorite sweater that I own. I love that it's my mom's as well. If you guys have a fashionable mom, you need to be over in her closet. My mom has given me some insanely beautiful sweaters. Again, another reason I really like that sweater is just the fit is perfect. It's just chunky enough, but it's not really, really chunky. I don't really find this sort of color scheme within this style of sweater. A lot of them are like navy, red, and blue. It's very Christmassy, but this can be worn all winter long. I don't think it's like reads as a Christmas sweater, which I mean, I also like those sweaters too, but just personally for me, I find that this color scheme is gorgeous. Another sweater that I really enjoy, and this one is from Macy's, I believe. It's their Cashmere Charter Club. This is 100% cashmere and it's a size small. It's this beautiful gray boat neck sweater. They make these in every color that you could ever want, but this is a perfect sweater if you just want a sweater to put on and feel really cozy and not worry about having a shirt under it. Uber soft. This is probably like the softest piece of fabric that I own. Cashmere can be really, really expensive, but I always find that Macy's has a really good deal on some of their cashmere. Not all cashmere is created equal. There are definitely some cashmere sweaters that I just don't find are up to par, and like, you know, they can charge you $100, but it still isn't super, super soft. This one was not that expensive at all, so I just really, really love it. Beautifully soft. Another sweater I really enjoy, this one from Polo Ralph Lauren. Again, it's 100% wool, and it's a very beautiful, chunky, navy sweater. Again, this is kind of just a staple product. Go to your local thrift store or a Goodwill and check out the men's section. I honestly can't remember where I got this one. It's either my mom's or was a gift from my dad, maybe? But yeah, look for these classic kind of sailor styles if that's what you like. Again, when you get a good vintage sweater, or even if you invest in a new one now, you want something that's going to last a long time, and this one certainly has. And lastly, let's talk about two cotton sweaters that I own. So the beautiful thing about cotton sweaters, these are both 100% cotton sweaters, is that they're just so freaking comfortable. This style, this is a fisherman style sweater. This one was from American Apparel. They just go with everything, you guys. This is an extra small. It's this really beautiful striped looking sweater. I bought this in the summer. This is a really good summertime sweater. It's kind of more preppy. I really like a classic kind of French sailor look in the summer and really all year round, but I find that I go from like skiing in the French Alps during the winter to more like sailing in the French Riviera in the summer. That's kind of my vibes. So I really, really enjoy this. I've had it for years, guys. So it's still just as soft as when I had it. It's worn for a really long time. I've put this through the wash. Like, a cotton sweater is so much easier to maintain than a wool sweater, because you do have to be careful with wool. If you, again, put it through the wash, it will shrink up and you just won't get the same fit. And possibly one of my most worn sweaters ever is this black fisherman sweater. It's gorgeous, and I also really like it because it's not super structured. It really drapes over the shoulders in a pretty way. Again, the cotton is really soft and it just goes with everything. So I just find that this sweater is a go-to. It's just a black basic fisherman sweater, and I've bought a lot of them from American Apparel. I will try and link exact products, but if I can't find exact products, again, like with some of these vintage pieces, I'm not going to be able to, but I will try to link products that are as close to what I'm talking about as possible. Let me know if you guys want to see more like fashion-oriented videos. Again, this is the first video I've ever done on anything like this. I hope that it wasn't weird. I'm not a model, so I apologize for the weird B-roll. Let me know any ideas for videos of this style if you guys want to see them, and I hope that you guys are having a good one. Have a beautiful, wonderful holiday, and I will see you in my next one.